Hi, hello, how are you? My name is Daryl Bingaman. I'm 30 years old, Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, and aka Ego.
Alright, well, I started tattooing when I was like 14. We're in Boy Scout. We're deep in the jungle. Everybody started building flags for Boy Scout. I'm over there building a tattoo machine. And start tattooing myself and start tattooing everybody else in that camp. And I was 14 when I did it, and I'm still tattooing till now.
What'd you build a tattoo machine out of?
From a radio.
From a radio?
Radio and a needle. some MacGyver shit, man.
So you do all kinds of artwork then, right? Like, what else do you do besides tattooing?
Paint, do a little sculpture, do some kind of music. Horrible singer now. That's about it. I'm pretty much with business and family.
What about your family? What family do you have here?
I got my aunt and her kids, and I have my own family now. I got two kids. I got an 8-year-old and a 3-year-old, Aaliyah and Amaya, and they basically with me all day, every day.
And you came over here from the Philippines?
Yep. I came here in 2000, and when I came here, I packed my tattoo machine. I told them I'm gonna be a tattoo artist. When I got here, my tattoo machine's not in the bag, because I guess my family didn't believe tattooing age 17, I guess. So they throw all my equipment. I was mad, but I can't do anything about it. I gotta live with them.
Downtown's hottest Latin spot. A tribute to Latin lifestyle.
Can't even count them up in the shop very weak. I can't seem to get enough. My aunt say my skin too clean to mark it up, but I'ma
ink my whole body. I don't give a motherfuck.
I'm blowing perp, no shirt. Windows down, screaming cash rules, showing off my tattoos. Hoes spazzing when they see me. Run up on me, starstruck, asking can they read me. Make it look easy. People say I'm crazy. Body marked up like a wall in the 80s. Speakers scream loud like the car full of babies. Chain so sick, think my charm came with rabies. All I hear these days is
I think you're going overboard with it.
I ain't addicted, I'm committed.
Now greetings to the world. Vice of the one big gangzilla alongside Skrillex. Them for no. Ooh-wee.
We must rock the place, turn up the bass and make them all have fun. How we ablaze the fire, make it fun. Them we must rock the place, turn up the bass and make some sound. Why run? The bass and make them all have fun. Skrillex, I blaze the fire, make it fun. Then we mash up the place, turn up the bass and make some sound. Boy, run. And we will end your week just like a Sunday.
Rumble.
All right, this is the waiting room. This is the waiting room. And this is the kitchen. This is where I cook. Yeah, this is all the little Eagle Ink magic comes from. Not much, but just it's something. Got a little mural, got a little painting in the wall, everything I did. Trying to do 1 hour every day painting, so all the paintings there is all 1 hour.
You've got a passion. You've got a passion. It's called peace. You've got a passion. You've got a passion.
We put it everywhere. It doesn't matter. I'm the Mad Hatter. Oh, come on down to Eagle Inc. 979-9705. Say it again. 717-979-9705. My Kung Fu is better than yours.
Stolen from an African land, chased out with a knife, with a face like Bob Marley and a mouth like a motorbike. Oh well, the bars are always open and the time is always right. And if God's good word goes unspoken, the music goes all night and it goes. If I were Bob Marley, I said, could you be loved? And if I was half pint, I would whip a Lord up above. If I was Mike Tyson, I would look for a fight. And if I was a boomer rat, I would be staying up all night. If I was a king of rock, I would get stupid dumb. And if rhymes were Valiums, I'd become the number, 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 number. You know what I'd do? I'd point that shit straight at the sky and shoot heaven on down for you. Because the bars are always open and the time is always right. And if God's good word goes unspoken, the music goes all night and it goes. I want a lover, but I can't find the time. I want a reason, but I can't find a rhyme. And I want to start some static, but I can't afford it. It's slammed with the ground like I fall off my skateboard. Hey, nowadays, it's clear as you please. Get strapped with protection or strapped with disease. Laughter, it's free. Anytime, just call me. 439-0116. When you die with sublime, you get funky, fresh, and getting up in it.
Stolen from an Africa land, I chased out of the bar. I saw my best friend tonight, so don't push me too far.
I'm seeing, man. Get comfortable, man. Just chill, man. Let's chill. Relax, man.
I'm relaxed. Are you?
Yeah, cool. Alright.
My name's Carlos. Nice to meet you.
What's up, man? My name's Hugo.
Alright. So, man, how old are you?
30 years old.
30 years old?
Yeah.
30 years young?
30 fucking years young.
What's your hometown, man?
I'm from the Philippines, but right now I'm in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania.
Alright, how do you like it out here?
It's cool.
Sorry. What's most important to you in your life?
It's my art, you know. I've been doing this shit basically since I was a little baby and shit, so this is the only thing I have and I know, and that's the only thing I live by.
So is that like what you mostly do with your time? What do you do with your time?
What do I do with? I mostly tattoo all day, basically, and in between that, I'm also a full-time dad, and take care of my kids, and basically business, my art, and my family.
That's legit. Who are your sworn enemies and why?
Ooh. Shit, I don't even know what to do, man. I'm gonna say my ex-business partner, you know, that dude, Mr. G. Yeah, he's just a douchebag. Fucking over in business. And, you know, I'm still here right now, though, you know? Took everything away from me. But that's life for you. That's learning.
What is your family home like? What's your family like at home?
Shit. Just like everybody. Yeah, just like everybody's family, you know? They just... We're close.
Alright, so, what is your family like at home?
Yeah, cut this shit. Family like at home. Shit. They're good. We're good, you know? We stick together. But, you know... Family, just like everybody, you know.
How are you in competitive situations? What are the pros and cons of your competitiveness?
Basically, all my life, I'm competing for life, period. So, you know, I always have something to prove, and ever since I was, you know, a buck, you know. Everybody said to do this, do that, and do this, and you know, even stick to doing what I'm doing right now, since I was 14, you know, I don't even be here right now, because I'm trying to prove everybody, you know, that it's alright, yeah.
What sets you apart from the people around you?
Shit. My animation. It's just me. I like being different. I like thinking outside the box. You know, that's why I'm my own breed, basically. When I do tattoo, I like my style. It doesn't even look like tattoo. That's what I'm trying to get away from. I want to be just always unique. I mean, I'm a fucking dress or Asian guy with a mustache, and you know, outside the box, you know, can you go and shit.
Of course. What do you do for fun on spare time or around the shop area?
I watch midget porn. Yeah, they're pretty good to watch, you know.
And what exactly do you do all around in your life? Like, period. What do you do from morning to night?
Work tonight. So yeah, I woke up like 6:30 in the morning, 7 o'clock. Make my kids breakfast. Get them done, getting ready for school. And after that, take them to that school bus. Then I have my alone time to actually reply to all my emails and message. Then open up 12 tattoo till 8 o'clock. Then you know, cook dinner. Put him to the bed and, you know, do it all over the next day.
Little girl.
An underdog, you know, like I feel like all my life I've been turned down so much and I have to teach myself, so I have so much to prove to the whole world that I need this. And not only that, you know, I'm a single dad, I can use the extra business.
How would this change your family's life?
Shit, man, well, we're poor right now, we're gonna be semi-poor, and that's the goal, you know. I'm trying to move on from rice to mashed potato.